Hello, everybody out there in Facebook land. Barb here with barbstamps.com. Whoa, I can't even say my own thing. Barb here with barbstamps.com, and welcome to a Facebook Live show. My regularly scheduled Facebook Live show, Thursday evenings, 4 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Mountain, 6 p.m. Central, 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Welcome, everyone. I am really excited to be here tonight because we have new catalog products to play with. And honestly, I just got my new catalog. Okay, as demonstrators, we can pre-order select items from the big catalog. And so I did that back in April, and I've been playing with those a little bit. And then, of course, May 4th, which was Tuesday, we could then order everything in the catalog. So I did place my order. I did expedite it. Don't tell my husband. And it got here about an hour ago. So I don't have projects designed with that stuff because I didn't have it to play with today. And in case you guys aren't aware, Dina Kelly and I are doing a fantastic new catalog kickoff on Facebook here. Links in the description of this video. It is $10 if you are not on our team and you are not a member of Stamp Happy Academy. If you are on our team, at least all my team members, I've invited every single one of you, so you should all be in the group. If you're in Stamp Happy Academy, there is a link in the description of this video for you to click to the, it will take you to the events tab on the Stamp Happy Academy website where you can register for the catalog kickoff. If you're a member, it's free. Lisa, I just saw you on here. I did invite you, Lisa. You should get into the group. If you haven't, maybe you have. I've been super busy trying. Something like this takes a lot of hours and planning and everything. We have about 500 people already in the group, you guys. Whoa. And we have to manually approve everybody. So if you are a Stamp Happy Academy member and you click on the link to get to the Facebook group, there are a couple questions you have to ask. And then we get a notification. So-and-so wants in the group. We have to go look. We have to see that you are, okay, so Barb wants to get in the group and Barb says she's a Stamp Happy Academy member. We have to literally go to Stamp Happy Academy, look at Barb and make sure she is a member and approve her. So there is some time involved in getting 500 people into a Facebook group, but we rock and we have 500 people in there almost. So anywho, if you are not a Stamp Happy Academy member, oh no, Lisa, it goes for like 2 weeks. It started on Tuesday and it goes all the way through next week. We have stuff. I have a calendar here loaded with things that we are doing. Loaded. We have prize patrols. We have 9 prize patrols. We have posted numerous engagement graphics that are super fun. We have 3 live classes scheduled, one from each of us. And in each of those classes, we give away a bundle. The only thing you have to do to be eligible for the prize patrols is be in the group. You don't have to do anything but be in the group to be a part of the prize patrols. If you want to participate in the card challenge, there's another prize for that. If you want to participate in mystery stamping, which I will be posting on Sunday, there's a prize for that. So there is a ton of stuff going on this group, you guys. And if you're not Stamp Happy Academy members and it's $10, it'll be the best $10 you've ever spent, guaranteed. So anyways, the link to purchase to buy the $10 admission is in the description of this video. If you're not a Stamp Happy Academy member and you're not on our group, and you guys, a bunch of you were already commenting about how much fun it is. It is, we are having so much fun. And yes, it's a little stressful behind the scenes, but we kind of thrive on that. Honestly, we seem to do our best work under the gun. So, yeah, Debbie said, well worth the 10 bucks. It is. And if you're a Stamp Happy Academy member, it's free. So it's well worth free. So yeah. And yeah, you guys should absolutely get it. And just as a little teaser, as soon as I'm done with my Facebook Live here, we are going live in that catalog kickoff group as a meet and greet, ask us question kind of thing. So yes, so exciting. And I fixed myself up so I look pretty. So I'm ready to go from here over to that. I'm getting my hair colored tomorrow. You guys probably can't tell, but it is, whoa, it is bad. The gray stripe is bad. And I'm very excited to get my hair fixed because I'm going in to get my eye sliced open on Monday. Yay! A Another very exciting thing. So I'm just giddy with excitement. My new catalog order came in. I am doing our Stamp Happy Academy. No. Catalog kickoff meet and greet tonight. I'm live for you right now. I've got fantastic projects to share with you. And I'm sure we'll have some shenanigans along the way because whenever I'm stamping, there's always some shenanigans because I'm not the best stamper. I mean, I make cute stuff. There's no doubt about that. But just sometimes my process in getting to the cute stuff, I make mistakes. But lucky for you, that's how you learn how to stamp, is you make mistakes and you fix them. So I do that a lot. Oh, Cynthia just said she's gotten her $10 worth already and it's only been going on for 2 days. So we still have like 9 or 10 more days to go. So yeah. Plus, for the first time ever, we were doing a make and take packet. So we are going to be demonstrating some of our we're going to have 9 projects in the make and take. So Kelly's designed 3, I designed 3, Dina designed 3. We're using 3 bundles and 1 stamp set out of the new catalog. So we're using the Party Puffin stamp set. We're using the Sweet as a Peach bundle, the Sending Hugs bundle, and the Expressions in Ink suite of stuff. So those are the 4 things that we're using. And so we're going to be demonstrating our cards in our lives along with other projects. So I think we're each going to do like 6 projects in our lives. And 3 of those will be part of the make and take packet. So you can purchase a make and take packet if you want to. They're $48. Unless you're one of our team members, then you get a $10 discount. And all that information is on the catalog kickoff group. We're going to be going over that tonight in the meet and greet. But just want to let you know that. And then you can add on the bundles if you want. So yeah, I don't have my link in the description of this video. Shoot. I'll try to put it in there after I'm done being live. So you don't have to be a part of the catalog kickoff group to purchase the make and take projects or the bundles that go with it. You can go to, do I have it posted anywhere? No, I only sent it out in an email, but I'm going to put it on my blog and I'll try to put a link to this in this description of this video too. Anyways, that's a first for us. So we're really excited about that because a lot of times, when you do demonstrations of things, people want to buy the kits to make what you're making. So we listen. We listen to you guys. If you've got suggestions for stuff you want us to do, let us know because we're happy to, try to accommodate suggestions and requests. So there you go. Okay. Oh, one little tiny little housekeeping thing. For those of you guys that know that I do these Designer Series paper chart kits. These are the ones that I have done so far because I didn't have any all the Designer Series papers. Anyways, I sell these kits, but I sell a limited number of them and I have 1 left. So there is a link in the description of this video. If you click on it and it takes you to my blog, that means they're sold out. So there is 1 left. They're $30. That includes 12 printed sheets. Each of the sheets are printed with the information. Then you get the 2x4 pieces of Designer Series paper. You cut them in half, you flip one, you glue them on. You get all the little pre-punched cardstock circles that coordinate with. This particular one here, you'll get the sheet that tells you about it. This is the host paper here. I'm randomly giving 3 people the pieces to make the chart. Everybody will get the chart, but 3 people are getting the pieces to make the chart, plus all of my team members that purchased it from me will get the supplies to make this piece here. Everybody will get the supplies to make the other 11. So you'll all get the pieces to make the pansy. You'll all get the pieces to make the beautiful whatever, beauty of the earth. You'll all get the pieces. So anyways, I have 1 left. So I limit it to 35. I take an entire piece pack of Designer Series paper, I cut it up, that gives me 36 charts. Well, I need one, so I sell 35 because they are so labor intensive, you guys. So yeah, 1 left. So somebody buy that, then I'll be done. Okay. I think I'm gonna flip the camera now because we have to get stamping because I have to get done with this and then try to throw some groceries down my neck. Hopefully I can. I guess if not, I'll be eating a granola bar on the next live. And then we're live again. So we're live on the catalog kickoff group at 5:30 Pacific, 6:30 Mountain, 7:30 Central, 8:30 Eastern. So if you're already in the group, you can check the schedule at the top of the group that has everything listed on there. And we're going to be streaming it live to the group. So you will be finding that in about an hour and a half. So okay. Let me kick my stool out of the way. Let me flip my camera. Oh, there we go. Okay, and I gotta adjust my camera mount. As you guys know, I hate that I have to do that, but I have not figured out how to do this to where I don't have to mess around with my camera mount. So my apologies. All right, let me adjust this view a little bit. Okay. So as we talked about, catalog kickoff party. And can I just say, we're having an ordering special, and this is one of the prizes for ordering. If you spend $75 with any of us, order from your demonstrator that you've been working with, we're all giving away the same thing. We're giving away these in color gems, and I have to tell you, I was a little skeptical about these because we had the butterfly ones last year, and I didn't really feel like they matched that great to the old in colors. But I'm telling you guys, these are like spot on. These are beautiful, and they have like facets on them, and so they kind of catch the light. Oh, they're really cool. Anyway, so that's a prize, along with multiple other prizes. Okay, catalog kickoff. Like I said, links in the description of this video. So check that out. We already talked about it. We don't need to talk about it again. Stamp Abbey Academy. If you're a member, you get it for free. If not, you should join because it's amazing. And there's a lot of gals that are on here right now that are in it, and they will comment and tell you how amazing it is. So take their word for it, not mine, even though I'm biased and I do think it's amazing. You can go to stamphappyacademy.ning.com and you can sign up there. Okay. Ooh, we have a special going on right now, you guys. For anybody who places a $250 order, I don't judge. If you want to place a $250 order yourself, you should. Lord knows I did multiple times. You're going to get an extra $25 in host rewards. So I probably got a few extra $25. I can't say how much because that might. What if my husband's friends were on here? That'd be terrible if he found out how much I spent. No, I'm just kidding. He doesn't really care. Anyway, so if you have a $250 order or you have some friends that you want to get together with and make an order, I can give you a host code. You and your friends can order online with your host code, and then you can collect all the freebies if that's what you want to do. So if you are interested in getting your own host code, please email me, barb@barbstamps.com, and I am thrilled to work that out with you. Okay. Ooh, then another bonus is right now, if you join my Stampin' Up! Team of demonstrators, and can I just say, you get the catalog kickoff party for free, and you get Stamp Happy Academy for free too. So much free. So much free. You also get an extra $30 in your kit, and you can get it all out of the new catalog. So you would get $155 worth of Stampin' Up! Product for $99 plus tax if you have tax where you live. There are some states that don't have tax. That's why I always say that. So yeah, and then of course I would welcome you to my team. We have a lot of fun. We do a lot of collaborative things with Kelly and Dina. Plus, we do some things on our own. I have monthly team meetings. I give away prizes. We just have a lot of fun. I think some of my girls are on here right now. So yeah. Oh, Sonia just said Stamp Happy Academy is really amazing. She's a premium member, and that's the best deal. And she's not wrong about that. Thank you, Sonia. Okay, my Create Where You Are class to go for the month of May is, oh, let me find it, the Flowers of Friendship bundle, which of course is the stamp set and the coordinating punch. Now, if you guys are Stampin' Up! Demonstrators and you saw my presentation at the On-Tour events last month, you know that I've got amazing projects with this bundle of stuff. I had way too much fun making tons of cards with this. And so, yeah, this is my bundle kit of the month. So you would need the bundle, whether you buy it from me or you have it yourself, you're going to need that. And then from me, you're going to get a packet of goodies along with your cardstock pack to make your 8 cards with envelopes. You're also going to get a half a pack of the Sweet Symmetry Designer Series paper. Look how cute those patterns are. They're so cute. And then there's some really nice plain-ish ones on the back. You're going to get a roll of the Flirty Flamingo gold ribbon. I should open this because I'm going to need one myself anyway. And so look at that. It's like got this gold. It's so pretty, and it's on both sides. So you're going to get the Flirty Flamingo with the gold, and then there's also this Just Jade, and they both coordinate really well with the paper. And the Just Jade, where's the end? Oh, it's right here. Well, it also has gold in it too, so cool.
Then you're going to get a package of the silver and clear epoxy essentials that have like teardrops, diamonds, and circles in clear and kind of a silvery. Anyway, it's a great deal. You get all that for $45. Then if you want to add the bundle, you absolutely can. If you already have it, awesome. Just get the kit. Of course, the links are in the description of this video. It's going to go live on May 20th, which means I will be sending out the PDF and all the kits on the 20th of May. So definitely subscribe to that because it's going to rock. Not lying. Okay, then our collaborative online class for the month uses the hand penned bundle, which you've probably seen some samples used with these. The link is in the description of this video for my class. You will need the bundle. You will also need the Genial Gems. So if you order the suite, which is the dies, the stamps, you get the Genial Gems in the suite. Otherwise, you'll need them. So then in our cardstock pack, we are including the Genial Gems and two half rolls of ribbon, the mint macaron velvet, and then the Highland Heather, which is so pretty. Oh my gosh. Anyway, this class will have 9 cards. There's a cardstock kit that will go with this also for you with your kit. And yeah, the links in the description of the video. All right. Let me throw that over here. Then my Totally Techniques online club. I apologize to everyone who's in that. I am going to be filming my video this weekend and getting your packets out to you on Monday. My apologies. This new catalog has just kicked my butt. In Color Club, I still am taking signups. If anyone's interested in getting in on that, you can find all that information at this link, tinyurl.com/2021BarbsInColorClub. And I'm sure there's a link in the description of the video. There always is. I still have adhesive kits for sale. If you don't know what those are, oh my, I just about dropped my crown on the floor. Harsh. They come in these cute little striped bags. You get a seal, liquid glue, glue dots, dimensionals, a tear and tape adhesive, an adhesive eraser, a sand eraser, and a little ruler. And that's in the description box also. Okay, I still have a few. I think I have 6 of these boho classes left. And I think I have 5 of the posted for you if you happen to have this. It did retire. The stamp set did retire a couple days ago, but the punch is still available. All right, let's get stamping so that I can get to my next live event. All right. We're going to be using the old Flowers of Friendship bundle. Mandy, can you hold on to that for me, please? Thank you. And we're also going to be using the Suttles Designer Series paper stack because I have to tell you guys, I was not a huge fan of last year's. Chris, you use a sand eraser to erase little ink marks. If you get like a little speck, sometimes when you ink up your stamps, you'll catch an edge. You can use a sand eraser to really minimize the look of that smudge mark or that little extra ink that you get on there. They're really cool. All right. So I have to say, I wasn't really a huge fan of the prints in last year's papers, but I love these prints. Love them. I just feel they're going to be so much easier to work with. And I just like fun, happy prints. And these are fun, happy prints to me. So we're using the pool party. And let me get my stuff out here. Where's my supplies? Ooh, and I have a treat for you guys. All right, where is that die? What do I do with it? Oh, it's not this card. It's a different card. Hee. Lost my head. Okay. Pardon me, Mandy. Let's move this out of the way. All right. So we're going to be using a pool party card base. It is 4.25 by 11. Ooh, Mary says she loves the adhesive eraser. The whole kit is worth that. That's awesome, Mary. She's not wrong. And then I have a 4 by 5.25 inch piece of white that's going to go on the inside. From the hand penned bundle, the dies, there is this fun little scallopy thing. And so I cut a strip of pool party cardstock with this die. So I think it is. 155557. Yeah, it does go in here. I thought it did. Oh, there's a little trick for you guys. Most of our dies have a number imprinted on them, so you can find where they go. If you don't know what the number goes to, you can go to the online store and type it in, and if it's still a current product, it'll pop up and tell you what die set it is. Okay, so I did that. I'm going to end up cutting it down, so it was just a scrap that I had in my scrap bin. I then have a 2x3 inch piece of this pattern. Any of these patterns would work because they're super cute. And then I have a scrap of, what is that? Pear Pizzazz. But I also want to get myself a strip for my inside layer here. So I'm going to do a 4 inch piece, and I'm just winging this so that it's about that wide, which is maybe 3/4 of an inch. Plus, I need a piece for an envelope, which will be 2.5 by 6. So we are still on a quest, you guys, to use up this DSP. So anytime we can use up DSP, we're going to do it. Never knew the numbers on the dies. Yeah, and I don't know how long it's been like that, Carol. It's been a number of years. So it makes it really handy if you lose a die or you find a die. You're like, oh my gosh, where does this go to? And then you can find out. Okay, let me adhere this strip of DSP to the bottom. Is that what I want to do? Wait, I think I'm going to wait because I think I might want to stamp something on this. So hold, please. All right, so I also need scraps of Pool Party. Thankfully, like I always say, my scraps and everything are right here next to me. So that's quite handy. All right, so the Flowers of Friendship. I've got the two flowers and then the leaves. So I've got some tricks for you guys about how to use these stamps, okay? So first trick is the large stamp. As you can see, the punch, it's oriented up and down the petals. So if you actually stamp it, well, that's not going to be big enough. If you actually stamp it up and down, it's going to be really easy to put it into your punch and get it punched out. Okay. Then this little guy, as you can see, it's kind of turned a little bit. So we're going to stamp it the same way it's oriented in the punch. And here's another tip for you guys. While each petal looks different, and so you'd be wondering to yourself, well, how do I know how to orient it into the punch? They're not different. They look different. Like the stamped image part of it, like the little inside pieces, they look like they're different, but it's not. It does not matter how you stamp it. You can stick it in here and it's going to punch out every time. That does not make any difference, which is a huge, huge bonus, I think, in this particular bundle, that you don't have to worry about that. Okay, and then you take your little strip here, you slide that in, you punch it out. Of course, you guys know I'm closing my eye because I can't see. Cataract surgery Monday, woohoo! Okay, enough singing because nobody wants to hear that. Then on the leaves, again, you want to keep your punch. So this, the big leaf, I feel like this is the top of the leaf. So in my opinion, it's pointed downwards. I don't even know if that's a word, but that's what I'm going to call it. So I am going to stamp it on the edge downwards so that when I slide it into my punch, it's oriented the proper way and I can just crop it right out. And then on this side, I feel like the leaf heads upwards, the small one. So I'm going to use this edge of the paper and I'm going to stamp my little leaf upwards. Maybe that is a word. I don't really know. And then so it'll just slide right in and it'll punch out. So if you have a whole bunch, you can just stamp a whole bunch on here and you can just slide it, punch, slide it, punch, slide it, punch, slide it, punch, and it'll go really quickly for you. I only need one of each, but I did need two of the big flowers and one of the smalls. So then you have all these little bits that we're just going to get rid of. Find the trash here so I can put all the rest of my scraps of Pool Party back in my file folder. Okay. So here is a tiny little trick. Sometimes, because this card's going to be fairly monochromatic, but I wanted the flowers to be a little bit different. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to color them with a Stampin' Blend marker with my dark one. And that way, it kind of will look like I have another shade of Pool Party. And now I don't need to do the entire leaf down to the bottom because I'm going to cover it up with the next size. The only one that I'll have to do most of it on is the little one. Okay, so we're gonna do that. And so this just gives you another shade of Pool Party. It's another little tip. I am full of tips and tricks. Oh my gosh, you guys, I know we've talked about this before, but prom Saturday. And my son went and tried on his tuxedo yesterday. Can I just tell you? He is a cutie. I'm not gonna lie. His pants, he's like 6'3". So the pants were way too short. So they had to fix those for him, and he went and picked it up today and he said it was fine. But yeah, oh my gosh, he looked so good. My daughter had come home because she wanted to see him go to prom. And so we were both in the tuxedo try-on place, the bridal shop. And anyways, yeah, he just looked so good. All right, so I'm going to glue these flowers together. Oh, hold on. First of all, I'm going to use a bone folder and kind of curl them a little bit. Just because I feel like they look better if they're a little more 3D. So we're just going to curl them. And I know they look kind of weird without having the flower middles done. But trust me, it's not going to matter because you're not going to notice. You won't know that that didn't get colored. Okay, now we can do it. So anyways, I'm really excited to, they're going to dinner at a friend's. The parents graciously offered to make food for all the kids. There's going to be 10 of them, I think. And so then we all get to go over there after they're done eating and take pictures. So yay. Because like I said, my daughter never went to prom. She just never cared. And so this is my first prom experience. Oh, I should. I don't think he'll mind, Amy, actually. So I have one picture. It's on my phone. And of course, I'm using my phone right now, so I can't show you. But maybe I can post it. Or maybe when we're doing our little live in the catalog kickoff, maybe I can take a few mom moments and hold up my phone and show everybody how cute he is. Okay, how dapper he looks in his tux. Okay, so I'm going to put my piece of designer series paper like right here, right above the stitched line, because I want the stitched line to show because it's really cool. All right, so that looks even. And then I'm just going to snip that off. Oops. Ugh. Can't see. I can hardly wait to wake up. Actually, it'll be Tuesday when I get my bandage off and stuff. And I'll be able to see. I'm super excited about that. Okay. So then we're going to add this to the card. But I think I might. Well, no, I'm not going to. I was going to say I was going to pop it up, but I'm not. Anywho. All right, so I need those little gems. What did I do with them? I took them out because they're part of my class. And I thought to myself, don't lose them. I found them. They're on the floor. Okay, so here's these little silver, clear and silver epoxy gems. So I'm, of course, just going to use a circle because my flower is, it needs a circle. Oh, wait, that's a teardrop. Whoa, that's not what I wanted. This is what I want. Okay. There we go. And I'm going to put that right there. So let me glue this down. Well, we can use seal. If we can get it started. Oh, for crying out loud. Come on, you. There we go. So, yeah. I'm just kind of excited. All right. So right on the edge. So this is maybe a little bit of a new layout. I don't know. Maybe it's not. Okay, and then I have this Pool Party, what's it actually called? Pool Party Sheer Ribbon. And we are going to wrap it around from the inside of the card to the front. And we're going to tie it in a knot. So I've been kind of practicing this, you guys. I'm not going to lie, because I like to master things. I don't want to have to fuss around with putting glue dots under this and whatnot, so we're going to see if I can do it. Of course, now that I'm bragging about, oh, I'm getting so good at it, I'm not going to be able to do it. Okay. Eh, could be worse, but it could be better. It's not terrible. Okay. So I'm going to kind of put that right there. I need some scissors, some decent scissors. I'm not going to trim that off perfectly just yet. Okay. Then, of course, we have to put our little flower on. And since it already has dimension, because I fluffed up the petals, I'm not going to use a dimensional. Okay. There we go. We're going to stick that right there. You guys are probably going to recognize this if you saw my on tour presentation. I made a lot of cards just like this. Okay. Then we have our little leaves that we need to tuck under. Where's my tiny one? Oh, over here. I was going to say, I knew I should be careful. I'll lose it. So we can tuck the big one in. And these are a Pear Pizzazz is the color of paper that I used. I tried a few different colors. I tried soft seafoam and I tried granny apple green. And this one, I liked this one the best. Okay. So that is basically our card, except we need to put our sentiment on here. And we're going to use, I think we're going to go with the thank you for everything sentiment, because I always need thank yous. So I need a block. Here is a gigantic one. Whoops, that one's not going to do it. Oh my, come on. And you're looking for a specific block and you can't find it because you're live. And of course, nothing ever goes according to plan when you're live. All right, so we're going to use Memento. You could actually use Stazon if you want, if you're a big fan of having it be super dark. I'm going to practice first before I actually stamp it to make sure it's straight. Yes, okay. So I'm going to try to ink it up a lot and then stamp it right here. There we go. Thank you for everything. So now we have to do the inside. So I think what I wanted to do on the inside is I do want to stamp this flower. I should have already done this because it's going to need a couple minutes to dry. But I think I want to stamp the flower kind of off the page a little bit. And then maybe we will stamp the leaf kind of off the page also. Maybe a tiny one right here. There. Okay. So let me let that dry for a second. I'll clean up some of this mess so that'll help me waste some time. All right. Oh, I guess what I could show is I could show you in case you guys haven't seen them. Here are my other, these are the cards I actually showed in my presentation. It's exactly the same, except I used the crinkled seam binding ribbon. So I did this in Poppy Parade. This one is in Bermuda Bay and Coastal Cabana. That's an envelope for a different card. Gorgeous Grape. Pretty. Melon, or no, 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 Mango Melody. Really awesome. And Fleur de Flamingo. So yeah. I had a lot of fun making all these cards, so you guys can be rest assured that my class will be nothing short of amazing. So you should sign up. Okay, let me trim off. We might need to fuss with that a tiny bit. There. Okay, well, hopefully this is done. So let's go ahead and just kind of color this in. Maybe we'll put a little bit of the dark here at the base. And then we can use the light to blend that up. I'm honestly trying not to go over the black, if I can help it. I mean, obviously it's kind of difficult, but I don't want it to smear. Sometimes if you don't wait enough time, it can smear a little bit, and I don't want that to happen. So I'm trying to be careful. Oh, I need to scroll through the comments because I actually have a stamp set to give away. The same one I've been giving away every week, the Punch Party from Celebration. I think I've given away four now. This will be number five. I don't actually have the set with me, but I'm going to scroll through the comments here in just a minute and I'm going to pick somebody to win. So let me finish. This is Light Old Olive. We don't have Pear Pizzazz blends. So Light Old Olive is good. There. Okay. Now I'm going to add my paper to the bottom. Paper right here. Da-da-da. Get that on there. And I need to go through comments and see if anybody's asked me any questions. Sometimes you guys ask me questions and I'm so engrossed in what I'm doing that I don't check the comments. Thank you, guys. I was pretty happy with those cards itself. They always look better when they're in like a set, you know, like in a group. A bunch of pretty colors together always look really nice. Okay, so we'll do that. And then let me get an envelope. Let's add some adhesive, just a tiny bit of liquid glue. Very skinny beads, as you can see. You can probably barely see the glue. I can barely see the glue. Okay, and we'll just bump that right up to the fold line on the envelope. There we go. And then, as you guys know, you just need to snip around. And even if you cut off some of the envelope, which I always seem to do, it doesn't even matter. Nobody will know. And this is also a helpful way to get rid of your DSP, because I know that you feel bad about having it and having so much. So you have to use it. Okay. And there it is. So cute. I cannot tell you how excited I was when Stampin' Up! Contacted me and told me they wanted me to present with this, because I got this stuff really early, that we had another flower punch. I was just tickled beyond belief, because we needed another flower punch, and we needed one that it didn't matter. The orientation didn't matter. So you could just stamp it on a piece of paper, stick it in there and punch it, and you didn't have to try to fiddle around and go, oh no, it has to go this way, this way. So I was super excited about that. Okay, let me clean this up a bit and then we will move on. Oh, I have to show you something first though. Check this out. I made these charts to show everybody the different things you can do with this bundle. So here's the flowers. So here's one, here's two. Here's two bigs and a small, a big and a small, two smalls, a small pluffed up, a small and a big. Just look at that. And then here's the leaves where I put them all together and made it into a flower. And then you can cut the petals apart and you can actually check it out. You can make, so you could like stamp this whole thing and then you could stamp in colors and you could make it like a little bit 3D, which is really fun. Same with the small ones. And then I made this chart of different methods to color the flowers in, which this one I did use watercolor pencils. This is our Fluid 100 paper. This is gold embossing on the Hand Panda Designer Series paper and then punched out. So you can see you get that fun little polka dot and striped action there. This is some more of our Fluid 100 paper, and this is water painters and an ink pad. This is Stampin' Blends. This is just black on color. And then this is, I colored them with sponge daubers. So I'm hopefully going to put these on my blog with the cards, but I don't know when that's going to happen because, you know, we've got the catalog kickoff, which is really important, and I've been working on that right now. So, okay. I better put these stamps away so I don't make a mess with them. And I've got a little bit of trash here. I don't like trash. Okay. Next, we have this. So let me bring in the stuff for our next project. And maybe you guys have seen this. Oh, where is it? The color and contour bundle. Oh, I need to give away the prize. Jeez. Okay. Here we go. I'm just going to start scrolling through the comments. I know it's getting kind of wiggly, but I'm just scrolling through. La 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 la. Looking at random people's comments. And I am going to go. There's a lot of comments. I'm still scrolling, you guys. Awesome. Okay. Thank you so much for your comments. I know that really helps me out. Yeah. All right. Here we go. Here we go. We're going all the way back and then we'll come back down again and then we'll see what we can do. Okay, here we go. I am, how does that go? Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. No, I'm just kidding. Trying to see if there's like a name that I don't recognize in here somewhere. Let's go with, I'm going to say Amy Cosmo. I think that's your, how do you say your name, Amy? I am going to send you that stamp set. So I'm going to need you to Facebook message me or email me, barb@barbstamps.com. Looking for a pen. And give me your address and then I will get this out to you. Okay. So Amy is the winner of the stamp set. There you go. All right. So I've got your note here, Amy. I just need your address and we will take care of you. Okay, so the color and contour bundle is amazing, except it doesn't go with that. What am I doing? It goes with this. So anywho, this goes somewhere else. This is what we're going to use on the next card. We're going to use this little image here. And then I wanted a teeny tiny little image. So I just got my Sweet as a Peach stamp set. Yay! And I'm going to use this little tiny hello. Okay. So that's pretty exciting because I needed a tiny, maybe I'll use hello and friend. Who knows what I'm going to do. Okay. So let me get my, I have to show you. Look at how amazing these dies are though, you guys. They make scallop rectangles, which really makes me happy. But this little guy here, it also cuts slits. You can kind of see these slits around. So you can like thread ribbon underneath here. I should have die cut one to show you, but I didn't. Just trust me that it's amazing. Okay. I'm going to use that stamp set. Or that stamp. So there it is with this little filler piece. And that's not what I'm looking for. This is what I wanted to show you guys. Oh my gosh. This is another thing that I just got like an hour ago. It's a brand new die. It's called Stitched Greenery. You may not have even noticed it in the die sets in the back. But look at that. It's a bunch of stitched leaves. And so originally on my card, I was going to use the dandelion folder. But then I got this. So look, I'm going to use this instead. Look at that amazing stitching. OMG. I'm so excited. So this is going to be our layer on our card. And it's amazing. And then we have a Misty Moonlight card base that we're going to put that on. And the reason I chose these colors is because I am using, where's my chart? I wanted to use some of this fun paper in the Pattern Party. This is the host only set. So if you place a $150 order, you can buy this with your host rewards for 18 bucks. And it's a 48 sheet, 12 by 12 sheets, 48 of them. And look at all these fun patterns. They're black and white on one side, which also makes me very happy because we needed a black and white paper. And then there are all these fun patterns on the other. Okay. So that's the paper I wanted to use. And I wanted to use this pattern right here. And that's where I had that other die set out here. The tags. What did I do with them? I've got too many new things around here. Well, here we go. The tailor-made tags. That's where I got this tag from. So it does have stitching around it. You can't really see it, but I do have some white ones. Here we go. There's a white one of the one style, and here's a white of the other. So this, over on this side here, this is the top that you'll get on this tag, which is really cool. And they're all stitched. And then this is the top of these tags over here. So there's four different sizes of each tag. And then you get the little dots or tag. You can cover the tag so that it looks pretty. Anyway, okay. So we need this little small tag, this little small tag. And we need some ink. I need black. So I'm going to ink up this stamp, and I'm going to ink it in black, and then I need a scratch paper. Okay. This is one of those kind of fun sets that you can either color it in with blends or whatever you want to use, or you can use the stamps that come in the set. So let me just stamp that on there. I know, Carol, it's amazing. I saw it in the back of the catalog. I have to confess, I placed all my orders and then I was looking through the catalog because I really haven't even looked through the catalog yet. And I saw this in the back and I was like, oh my. So I had to place another order. And don't tell my husband, but I expedited that one too. Because I needed it today. I was hopeful that my UPS guy would show up and bring me my stuff so I could share it with you guys. And he did. He's a rock star. Okay. So then we have Pool Party Ink. And I'm going to ink this up. This is like the filler image that goes with this stamp here. So it's not designed to be perfect. So what I normally do is I line up this little bud up here at the top. You can see that. So I line up the bud and then I just kind of rotate this around until it looks kind of good to me. And then I stamp it. And it's not supposed to be perfect, and it's not, but I like it. Okay. So then there isn't a stamp that kind of fills in the leaves, but I kind of feel like you need to fill in the leaves a little bit. So I am going to use, I'll try light first. My light Granny Apple Green. And so I'm just going to barely throw some color in here. Just a little bit, just so that you know that it's leaves down here. I'm just going to kind of follow that. Yeah, just a tiny little bit. Nothing spectacular. Okay. Then I need my little sentiment here. So we're going to open up our peach set. Brand new. Oh, and you guys might notice that we have a new inserts in our stamp cases. If you get photopolymer stamps, they've actually printed the items that are in this stamp set on the sleeve here. And now, yes, they're backwards and upside down, but that's fine because that's how the stamps would be when you'd stick them down anyway, because they all have the flat back. So if you want, you can take them off of these plastic sheets and you can just like stick it in there, and then you'll know if you're missing anything and you can still see what it's supposed to be. Obviously, you'd have to be able to read upside down and backwards. So it's a little bit of a learning curve because I'm not used to having that like that. But I think in the long run, it's going to be good. So I'm actually kind of excited about it. Okay, there's my hello. I need a block. Here we go. There's our little hello. And now I couldn't decide if I wanted to stamp it in black here or if I wanted to stamp it in Misty Moonlight. So, where's my Misty Moonlight right here? I don't know. I feel like black is so harsh, but Misty Moonlight might be, well, you know, we're going to just go for it. And if it looks terrible, well, whatever. Okay. We're going to stamp that. I don't think it's going to look terrible. Okay. Oh, thank you guys for sharing the video. Please share it. I forgot to ask you that because sharing really helps a lot with the algorithm of Facebook and lets other people know that, hey, that amazing stamper Barb, no, I'm just kidding, but I, you know, I am kind of fun. Barb is live right now. Okay. So then as I showed you on that die set, where did I put it? You get that little, it does four little circles at the same time. And so here are a few. So I am going to add this little circle at the top here with a glue dot. Because who's got time to fiddle around with getting adhesive on there? Oh, oops. Press it onto the dot. Pick it up. Put it up there at the top of the tag. Ooh, that's cute. Then we have some ribbon. I'm gonna find it. This is the Pale Papaya Weave, something weave, open weave ribbon. Thank you guys so much for sharing it. I appreciate that. And I'm going to make a little bow. And, oops, that did not work out. How are we doing for time? 5:48. Because in case you guys just started joining us, Dina Kelly and I are going to be doing our meet and greet on our new catalog kickoff page, which you can find. I can't talk and tie a bow at the same time. You can find the links to everything in the description of this video. The catalog kickoff group is free to Stamp Happy Academy members and our team members. If you're not a Stamp Happy Academy member or a member of one of our teams, it's only $10. And it's like a 2-week thing that we're doing. I started on Tuesday and tonight is our meet and greet live video. So I have to be done here by 6:30, which I'm usually done anyway, but I do kind of want to eat. Okay. That took way too long. Sorry. Oh, obviously those scissors are crap. I need to pull these out. I really wish Stampin' Up! Would not have stopped selling these because these are literally my favorite ribbon scissors ever. Okay. So then we're going to attach this to our little dotty thing there with another glue dot. And we're going to pick up the Pale Papaya that's in this little piece of paper here. Okay. So yeah, anyways, what I'm saying, we're going to be live. And oh my gosh, Kay said she found us because one of you guys shared it. Yay. Thank you so much for sharing and welcome, Kay. I hope you enjoy yourself here. We always have a lot of fun on Thursday nights. I'm live every Thursday night at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 Central, 5 Mountain, 4 Pacific. Yeah. Okay. So we have our little tag. We're going to stick it on that. But we do need one other thing. Where is it? Here it is. This is a little strip of pale papaya, and I do have to stamp on it. Because, where's all the rest of the stamps? Oh, hold on. All right, what is this in? Is this in the stamp? Yes, so I've got this little bunch of dots here, blobs. And, ooh, Pat says she's looking forward to the meet and greet. Patricia, I mean, Pat, sorry. Maybe that's your nickname, Pat. Patricia. So yeah, the meet and greet's going to be fun. We actually posted a post on the page, and we asked you guys to give us some questions that you want to know about us. And so we're going to be answering some of those. So that's going to be really fun. And we will probably have our crowns on because that's kind of what we do. So yeah, it should be a lot of fun. Okay, so I just did some blob stamping on the ends of that. And I'm going to use my little grid paper here. It doesn't matter that this is the metric side. I just need lines to help me line it up. And I'm going to use this line right here. And this grid paper is our Stamparatus grid paper. Super cool. Okay, that's a tiny bit too long. So we will snip that off. And then we're going to add this with some dimensionals. And it is a little bit bowed. I ran it through my, of course, Stamp Cut and Emboss machine. And it bowed it a tiny little bit. So we're just kind of rolling that back the other direction. Okay. That. Get all these off. And then our card base is a Misty Moonlight. Oh, I gotta be careful. You only get one chance, kind of, when you're using dimensionals. Sort of, kind of. Oh, she usually goes by Trish. Okay, perfect. All right, so then I'm gonna kind of put these together somewhat, glue them together. So I'm just gonna add some glue back here. And I'm gonna put it next to this one. So I want a little bit of it showing because it's cute. The paper on it's super cute. And see, black and white on the back. That makes me very happy. Okay, I'll stick that. Oops, I'm gonna pick that up just a hair. Do that. Okay, and then I have an inside layer, of course. And I have more Designer Series paper that we can put at the bottom just because it's fun. There we go. Whoops, I want the bumps to be up just because that's what I want. I figured it was a tiny bit long. Ooh, Evelyn says the ribbon is pretty. It is really pretty. And it seems to tie very nicely if you're not trying to... oh, thank you so much. Cynthia just posted the time. Meet and greet's at 8:30. So as soon as I sign off, I'll be signing back on in the other group. And we will be doing our meet and greet. So yay. So we have about, what time did I say it was? It's 5:53. We got about a half an hour before our little meet and greet will start. Okay. I know, so do I. Connie says she likes the two tag look. I do too. And that's another way to use up more Designer Series paper, you guys. So if you're ever just making a tag, throw a pattern behind there because it's cute. Okay, so then I think I'm going to just go with some plain old rhinestones on this because that's what I want to do. All right. And I don't know, maybe some tiny ones? Where do I want them? Ooh, maybe. Maybe like that. I got an idea. It might be terrible. It might not be terrible. Sometimes this stamping on the fly is kind of fun. There, how about just like that? Ooh, I could stamp something on the inside. What could I stamp on the inside? I have hello. Ooh, you're absolutely amazing. That's good. All right, let me find a block. Here's a block. And I'll get it on here. And then I think we're going to use Misty Moonlight again to go on the inside. Okay. And I got the old eyeball closed. If you guys are new here, I am having cataract surgery on Monday. I am legally blind in my left eye, and I'm really excited to get that cataract removed so I can see. So I'm basically a one-eyed stamper, and I have been for a long time. So anyways, there it is. How cute is that, you guys? You know what? What if I threw some Wink of Stella on there, like on these flowers? Could I? Should I? She's doing it. I mean, honestly, can you really have too much? I mean, if you're going for flowers and you're going for bling, can you have too much? I think not. Oh, I might have got a little carried away. Okay, yeah, there's just a little bit of shimmer on there now. Okay, let me put some of this stuff away for our next project. I don't need these. That I don't need. I don't need this ink. I should maybe clean my stamps really quick. Just because I feel like since I'm going to have to quickly go from this to another live event, I don't want to leave my stamps inky because I don't want to forget and have them get ink all over other stuff. Okay. Oh, this is something I wanted to show you guys. Totally off topic, totally off task. I just saw a squirrel and I ran after it. This is sitting on my desk. This is a brand new item in our catalog. It's called the Expressions in Ink Ephemera Pack. And I saw it in there, but I didn't realize that it had these fun little, what are these things called? Sequins. And so I had to quickly, of course I had to add this onto my last order that I did. So look, they're clear and they have sticky on them, which is super cute. But these little pieces here, oh, get back in there. Why is everything so hard when you're trying to be fast? Okay, look, they're gold. Look at these fun things. I didn't really realize what it was. And then I was finally reading the catalog and it said what it was. And all right, I just got my order about an hour ago. So I haven't even had a chance to do anything with this. So these are a little fussy. Of course, if I wasn't live, it wouldn't be so hard. Ah, so you pull these apart. They're like little frames. Look how cool that is. Where's something white? Ugh, here's something blue. Look at that. If you could put that on a project, that would be really, really cool. You could stamp something inside of it. I'm excited. And then the rest of them are leaves. I think all the sheets are the same. I think. Let me peek in here really quick. Yes, it does look like all the sheets are... Oh, no, I lied. Here's another one. Here's a different one. And I like that they're separated by these tissue papers because these things can, like, be a real pain. They can get stuck on each other and stuff really easily. So here is another pattern. Oh, no, it's the same. This one was upside down, and so I didn't... Yeah, okay. Barb is losing her mind. Okay, squirrel's gone. We're moving on. Oh, and look what I have on my finger. I'm going to put that somewhere where I won't lose it. Right there. Okay. I was cleaning up my mess. That's what I was doing. I'm going to use this stamp set again, so I'm going to keep that out. I'm not using the tags. I'm not using that amazing greenery folder. Am I using this? No, I'm not. Okay. I'm not using this. I'm not using that. I'm not using that. I'll probably use those. This. Okay. Oh, yeah, I have this thing for blue because they did two blue cards, but my next one's pink, so that's all right. Okay, so we are using the color and contour set again. We're going to use these two flowers this time. And here is a really fun set of dies. It's called Basic Borders, okay? And here's we're going to use a black card base, so it's 8.5 by 5.5. We have a fresh freesia. This is a brand new ink color for us. This is 4 by 5.25. Then I had a 4 by 5.25 inch piece of white that I used my basic border dies on. These are fun. Okay, so I used this guy here. Okay, but I did take the time to show you all the different borders. So here's the cloud. Isn't that fun? Look at that. Look at those clouds, and they have all the little stitching on them. So cute. Then we have the zigzag. which is really cute. So we have our little zigzag, and it does do the stitching, which is fun. Then we have this kind of like an envelope flap, I guess, in a sense. And so here, oh, do they? Gosh, I didn't even know that, Laura. Thank you. I think she's talking about these. Or no, maybe she's talking about that little ephemera pack. Sorry. Okay, never mind. I digress. Here's your little triangle guy. Here is just a nice, soft, rounded thing, whatever. And then this, I don't know what you call this. I don't know what you call that, but that's what it looks like. And then here's the one that I'm using today. So I kind of did all of our in colors on one of the borders, and then white, of course, for the clouds. So this is something that everybody is going to need. I have no doubt that you're going to want them, because they're going to be so fun. Okay, so that's what I did on that layer. I ran that through. So this is going to be a little too wide, as you can see. It's not what I want. So I'm going to cut it. And honestly, I'm not even going to measure it. I'm just going to cut it. I'm just going to cut some of it off, like that much. And then I'm going to stick it on here. So I'm going to have a little on this side and a little on this side when I get done. But first I have to do some stamping on this. So I'm going to use some Memento. What did I do with that? Here it is. So I'm going to stamp my flower in a Memento in a line down the piece of paper. So let me do this. And I'm going to stamp that one, and I'm going to ink it up again. I'm going to, don't do that. I'm going to rotate it just a bit, and then I'm going to pull it out from the edge. I better hold on to this. Okay, and then I'm going to rotate it again, and I'm going to come back into the edge and just slightly off of the edge. Okay. And then one last time, I'm going to come out from the edge again, and I'm going to rotate it just a slight bit. Okay. Then I have a sentiment that came out of this that says, thank you for everything. We're going to ink that up also. And then we're going to kind of put it right in here in this little area where we, I'm trying to make sure it's straight. Got my eye closed. Okay. There we go. Order of mine today. Okay. So we're going to close up the black. Whoa. Boy, I'm just freaking out now. I'm trying to hurry, but I don't want to hurry too much, because that's not fun if I'm hurrying. Okay, so I've got the fresh freesia ink, and then I have the other piece to this flower. Okay, but what I thought would be cool is if I took a sponge dauber, and I'm only going to ink up like the middle of this stamp, just in the center. I'm going to huff on it. And I'm just going to look through that little tiny hole there and make sure it's in the middle, and then I'm going to stamp it. So I'm just going to get a little bit of ink. Now, I will caution you that sometimes this can pick up the black. So we are going to clean it between, because I didn't really let that dry too long. And then I'm going to slap it on my hand to get the excess water off. Oh, wait, that's not, didn't I just say don't do that? There are days when I really need to just figure out what I'm doing. Okay. And we're going to go in the middle. Okay. We're going to huff on it. We're going to look through the little tiny hole in the stamp and make sure it's in the middle. And then we're going to stamp it. Then we're going to clean it, because like I said, it can pick up the black. We're going to slap it off on our hand, and we're going to do this again. Now, I feel like if you waited for the ink to dry a little longer, oh gosh, did I get lucky there or what? If you waited for the ink to dry a little bit longer, I feel like that we wouldn't have to clean it between each inking. But anyways, I thought this was kind of a fun way to add color to this without having to, line it up exactly and all that good stuff. If you were just trying to do a little bit of fun, quick stamping, I thought that would be a great way to do that. So anyways, there's a little tip for you. And so then we're going to glue this to this. So I need some glue. Okay, and then some glue here. And like I said, I want some border on this edge and on the other side, of course. So I've got my eye closed to kind of make sure that that's even. And I think it's too long. Yep. So I am going to just snip that right off. Okay, that's cute. And then I have my Fresh Freezer ribbon, and I'm going to tie a bow. Hopefully this one will go a little faster than the last one that I tried to do. Not sure what the heck, but anyways, yeah. Okay, I think the trick to this stuff is you kind of got to pull the ends tight. You got to get that knot pretty tight, I think is the trick. So, there. Use my ribbon scissors. There we go. And then I'm just going to tack that right underneath my thanks for everything with the glue dots that I just lost. Oh, found them. All right, so we will add our little dot. And I'm just going to stick that right there because I think that's so cute. Then I need an inside layer. Oh, here it is. I was going to say, I know I have an inside layer somewhere. And I'm going to do that same little technique down here in the corner. So I'm going to ink up that a couple of times. And I'm over stamping. I'm just going to do it in the corner. Oh, I'm not watching the comments. Thank you guys for helping each other out. I really appreciate that. I always do that. I get so engrossed in my stamping and I forget what I'm doing. And I don't ever look at the comments. All right, I'm gonna do the same thing. Stick it in the center. I wonder if I can just do this to get the black. And maybe there isn't any black. Maybe I'm just dreaming because I made another color I'm gonna show you guys in a minute here. I did this for a swap. And I was doing mass production and I was having a little bit of issue with my this stamp picking up the black. So that's why I did that. But obviously, right now, it doesn't seem to be giving me that kind of fit. So that's good. So there's our inside layer. Pretty. Okay, so I'll fold that in half. Where's my bone folder? Right here. Okay, and then we're going to get our adhesive on this. I think I'm freaking out because I'm always where I'm freaking out that I'm going to be late for our next live event. Oh, Pat says, I love this card. You are more talented than you feel you are. I really enjoy your videos. Oh, you're so sweet. I mean, I kind of know I make cute cards, but it takes me a long time. My thought process is just, it takes me a long time. I don't know why everything takes me so long. I think it's because I'm so anal. A lot of times that can be a bad word, but it is what it is. I am. I pay particular attention to detail on everything, and it kind of drives me nuts. Okay. We have that. Oh, that is really, I like that. Oh my, is that a little, nope. I was going to say, is there some ink on there that we have to get rid of? But I don't think so. So now, let me show you another card. Oh, I know what I'm not done doing yet. Where are my, here we go. Since we're doing black, we might as well use some black embellishments, right? So these are those black matte dots. They're currently in the January to June catalog. And they're carrying over to the catalog now. So, which is nice because I really think this is cool that we have a black embellishment. I like that. So I'm just going to add a few of these. Oh, wait. Oh, you know what? I forgot to do something. Hold on. I need to get a stamp out of this other bucket. Okay, so I forgot that I wanted to take the little Dottie stamp that we use on the last card right here, and we're going to do some Fresh Freesia. We're just going to kind of, let me cheat and look at my other card. We're just going to kind of add a little bit of this Dottiness here. There. That's what I wanted to do. Take my breath that Cynthia recommended and figure out what I'm doing. Okay, and now I can add my black dots. And another one right there. Oh, yes. Okay, look at that. So cute. And then you open it up, and it's so cute on the inside too. But If you're not a purple fan and you're a pink fan, bam, there's your pink one. The pink one is actually the one I did for my swap. I didn't actually put the ribbon on there, but as I was looking at it today, I thought, you know, I think it could use a little bit of ribbon. So that's why I threw that on there. So this is the new pink, polished pink. That's the Fresh Freesia. And let me bring the rest of the cards in. And again, I'll say it one more time. If you guys are in the catalog kickoff group, head over there in about, what time is it? In about 20 minutes, because Dina Kelly and I are going to be doing a live meet and greet in that group. If you want to get into it, there are links below this video that you can get into the catalog kickoff group. We are doing a catalog kickoff. It's going to be about almost a 2-week deal. When it's all said and done, it'll be about 2 weeks that we will have been doing stuff. We're giving away tons of prizes. We're each doing a live class in the group. The schedule's posted in there so you can find out when each of us is live. We're giving away a bundle on our live event. We are doing 9 prize patrols. We're going to have mystery stamping. We've got card challenges. We've got a ton of fun interactive posts that are on there right now that are a lot of fun for you guys. So head over there. Here's my cards again. Remember to, if you need supplies and you don't have a demonstrator, I would love for you to shop with me at shoppingwithbarb.com. I always have free gifts with purchase. You can check my host code in the description of this video. And I'll see you guys in about 20 minutes. And then again, I'll see you next week. Okay, bye-bye.